Hi all, how are you? Okay, so the last class we have discussed physical properties of metals and non-metals, and I have already given notes also. So many students send me the proof, so thank you. Now we can discuss the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay, so the chemical properties, first we have to study reaction of metals and non-metals with the oxygen. Okay, so the first one, reaction of metals and non-metals with the oxygen. Okay, so the first we can discuss the reaction of iron with the oxygen. Reaction of iron with the oxygen. I think you are familiar with the phenomenon rusting of iron. Okay, what is rusting of iron? You have already studied in 7th standard, rusting of iron. Rusting of iron means when an iron react with oxygen and water, on the surface we can see a brownish color. That means a new substance is formed there. That process is called rusting of iron. Okay. So, in this chapter, first we have to study the reaction of metals with the iron, and we have to check the nature of this rust. Is it acidic or basic? Okay. So, I have rust. I have collected some rust. Okay. Can you see this one? Now, we can check the nature of this rust. Okay. Rust means iron oxide. Now, we can check, is it acidic or basic? We can start the process. So I have rust now, and we have to add some water. Okay, I am adding some water, and we have to dissolve the rust in water. I am dissolving the rust in water. Rust will not dissolve completely in water. Okay. Now we can use this solution to identify, is it acidic or basic? Okay, iron oxide is acidic or basic. So for that one, we can use red and blue litmus paper. Now I am using blue litmus paper. Okay, now I am dipping this blue litmus paper in this solution. Do you observe any color change? No. Okay. So the next we can use red litmus paper. This is red litmus paper. Now we can use red litmus paper. Okay. Now we can see that the red litmus paper slowly changed to blue color. Can you see? Slowly changed to blue color. That means there is no change in blue litmus paper. No change in blue litmus paper. But the red litmus paper slowly changed to blue. That means, is it acidic or basic? Remember, is it acidic or basic? Red turns to blue. That means the substance is basic in nature. Okay, so iron oxide is basic in nature. Actually, when we dissolve this iron oxide in water, actually they form iron hydroxide. Okay, so that is basic in nature. Okay, now let us do another activity, that is the burning of, you already did that burning of magnesium in 7th standard. Okay, that also we can do now, and we have to check, is it acidic or basic? Magnesium oxide is acidic. Listen, now I am burning that magnesium ribbon, and we have to collect the ash. Okay, I got some ash, so I have collected the ash, and here also this one is magnesium. magnesium. Magnesium is a metal. When it burned, that means magnesium react with the oxygen. Okay, first one we already told iron. Iron react with oxygen. That it means the process is known as rust. Okay, here the magnesium we burn that one. So actually the magnesium is reacting with the oxygen, and we got white ash. Can you see that one? White ash. We got white ash. The next one we have to check whether it is acid or base. The same process we can continue. We have to add some water, okay, and dissolve the ash in water. Now the ash almost dissolved. Then the same process we can continue. What is that same process? We can use the red litmus and blue litmus to identify the nature of this magnesium oxide. Okay, so I am using both papers, blue and red. Okay, when I am using the blue litmus paper, is there any change? No change. The next one I am using red litmus paper. Here also we can see that the red litmus turns blue. It will take time, slowly it will change red to blue. Okay, some part is already changed to blue color. So this one also, the magnesium oxide also, is it basic or acidic? This also basic in nature. So in general we can say that metal oxide, we already did with the two, that is iron and magnesium. From these two experiment we have concluded that magnesium oxides are basic in nature. Okay, magnesium oxides or metal oxides are basic in nature. The next one, let us now observe what is the let us observe the reaction of nonmetals with the oxygen. First we have to take a gas jar with a deflagrating spoon and a lid. Okay, and after we have to take sulfur in the spoon and starts burning. As soon as sulfur starts burning, introduce the spoon into a gas jar, into the gas jar, and cover with the lid. When sulfur starts burning, it produces a gas sulfur dioxide. It traps inside the gas jar sulfur dioxide. Okay, and after we have to add water to the gas and shake it well. Now we will get the solution. We can use the solution for the test. We are adding that blue litmus paper to the test solution. We can see that blue litmus turns red. That means metal, non-metal oxides are acidic in nature.